Hello my magical light being and welcome to this video. My name is Shalita, welcome to this channel. This channel is all about magical consciousness. A message meant for you in this present moment, as I felt so called to do this message today. To explain a little bit before I will give this message, to explain why I felt like giving this message today. Because I woke up, I did not feel like, you know, setting my alarm or anything. I was like, why? Anyway, and then I was sitting in my bed. I was like, I don't feel like dressing up today. I don't feel like putting on makeup. I don't feel like going out of bed, actually. So I was sitting in my bed watching some YouTube videos. I was working on my own oracle deck, and then I received 3 cards from my own oracle deck, from my higher self, as I love to do this every morning, shape a card from my own made deck. And all the cards were about remembering your importance. And then I realized, I was like, whoa, a few years ago, it was 3 years ago in May, exactly in May, I was in the most depressed state of my life, I could say, the most darkest place. In that moment, I did not notice, but I was surrounded by 4 or 3 beings of negative energy, anything of this matter. Some people call it entities. Some people say hijacked. I personally don't like to use that, but That was what was happening back then. And I made another video about the ending of my dark night of the soul. It's on my YouTube channel, where I, the switch, the kind of the light was turned on for me for a moment in my room, in my body, my inner light. I saw my inner light again, and then I remembered my importance of being here right now. And this morning I realized that again. I was like, whoa, you know, I can hide away in my room, as I felt that really strongly in the energy today. I don't know if it's the weather, because we have storm, we have like a lot of wind, a lot of rain, a lot of clouds, and sometimes the sun comes through, but I felt like in the energies of, maybe there are a lot of people out there right now that are just sitting in their home and they feel like, you know, what's my life about? Am I like, is this going anywhere? Anything's matter, because I've been there too. And sometimes this comes still up in my reality, but not that heavily. I always want to say heavily, I say heavenly, but not that heavily anymore. So I know how to like switch it off for myself. Those negative thought patterns that love to hang around in the collective consciousness. Cosmic Empress on YouTube, she talked about this as well. She said that, you know, if you receive a negative thought or more negative thoughts at the same time, this can be literally, she said, a spell that has been done on the collective consciousness of everybody. You know, those clouds that the darkness tries to pull us back into more negativity and more darkness, and to allow us to, you know, spiral down in fear. And that is what I saw for myself as well. You know, if you are someone, you're just someone that, you know, is alive, being alive is so powerful, of course. And that is what I saw for myself, that a lot of people think they have their importance because of what they do, of what they accomplish, of how they show up. But it's not about how you show up, it's about that you show up, and it's about that you are alive. And that is what I realized 3 years ago when I came out of the dark night of the soul. It was a moment of, my mind wanted to link all that I was good at for a reason to stay on this planet, but you know, what if that falls away? Then there's no reason anymore. And that's really important for a lot of people. They are going to link their happiness to something outside of themselves, maybe in regards to how they look or what they're good at. And maybe, you know, that falls away. You see this with some people, you know, they attach their happiness, for example, to their athletic abilities, and then they break a leg or they will never be able to do that again. And then they can become so depressed because they attach their happiness to, you know, that athletic ability, that was the reason that they were alive. But there is actually no reason to be alive, only that you are alive. That's the reason of your life, that you're alive. And that's what I saw for myself 3 years ago, that life was looking out for me and that I deserve to be alive because I was alive. Life gave me life. And that was the only reason why I had to stay alive, because I was alive. You know, I could have died that morning when I woke up. I did not wake up anymore. You know, some people have this and they don't wake up the next morning because it was the end of their story. But if you're alive right now, if you're watching this, it's not the end of your story. And you know, we have this thing that we can actually end our own story, but that is something for me personally, a very deep topic to go into, where I have my personal point of view on, as this happened with me too. You know, that we have the ability to do it ourselves, but it's actually go against the law and the actual nature of nature. Because, you know, if we have to die, we will. We don't have to do that ourselves. But that is, of course, very important as well, if you're in that state of thinking, of being, to really seek for support, even if that's the most difficult thing in your reality. As for me, I had that too back then, that I did not want to tell anybody about how I felt, and I picked up the courage to do so with one person, and not even the whole story, but just a little bit, to feel even more seen, as it's just the eyes that look at you when you speak. Because we can feel so alone, and we can feel that we're not important, and it is a very emotional topic for me, as I try to hold it. My cry. My emotions love to flow out with this topic, but yeah, it's just very important to know that you are important just because you are here. And that's the message that I want to give today to all of you watching. If you were guided towards this video, because this video is meant for you in this present moment, I felt this in the energy, this energy of people not realizing how important they are, because they think their importance is attached to certain things, but their importance is just that they are important because they are alive and nothing else. Just you are being yourself is important. You just being however you feel, your life, that's important. That's the only thing that actually matters, that you right now actually incarnated in matter. Nothing else matters. Damn that. To remember your significance, because we can feel so insignificant. I felt that this morning, you know, like even with me having this YouTube channel, 1111 Make-A-Wish, even with me with having a YouTube channel or having a certain amount of followers, we still can feel insignificant if we don't see our significance ourselves. We can have so many people support us, but if we don't support ourselves, we don't feel support. If we don't show up for ourselves, nobody else will. And I was talking yesterday with the amazing guy I'm in a relationship with. We talked about this, that, you know, we have to show up for ourselves. And when you are, for example, right now I'm in a relationship, you have to, kind of have this double feeling of showing up, you know. If you are just by yourself, it's easier to say, okay, I'm just going to lay in my bed all day. But if you are in a relationship, you know, to show up for that person, you have to show up for yourself. And if you are not, you know, showing up for yourself, how can you then be able to give love to someone else and all that if you're actually not giving it to yourself? And that's so important with self-love for me. That took like a long time to learn to love myself, not for what I do, not for how I look, not for anything that I'm good at or anything of this matter, but just for being alive, that you can breathe, to appreciate your heartbeats, to appreciate all your organs that are working for you right now, that you have legs, and if you don't have legs, you know, that's still you're alive. And I am very good at tuning with energy, so I can feel that some of you maybe will get emotional, but that is great. To allow yourself to heal, feel, you know, how if you feel, you will heal. And I literally saw this truck outside of my window driving by that said careful. Not in a sense, I would say, to be careful, but to be caring fully for yourself, that is so important. When you just can talk without crying, the mood of my life. There's so much wind, air element is around us, change is here. So to know that whatever you're in right now, it's not set in stone. Things can always shift. And what I said, taking care of yourself fully is so important, because you are important and you deserve that. And we have to see that for ourselves. And I know that takes time and all of that, but to know that you are important because you are here. That's the message I want to give. That's the message I wanted to give to my past version. As my future self, as this is so cool for me always when I think about this, you know, when we were younger or when we were in a certain situation, our future self was as well already existing and already sending all these messages to our past self. And of course we have free will, so you know, we can always decide upon something else. But most of the time we will feel this, we will feel this support that is there from our future self, from our higher self, from our guides, our angels. They're always there. We can always ask, as with our guides and angels, I talked about this, how to know if you know, you're being guided by your guides or your angels. We have to ask for guidance. This is what I did, as I said that as well in the Dark Night of the Soul video. We have to ask. There are moments that we are contracted, we don't have to ask, as that is not our it's not even coming to our minds to ask for help, because we feel like, yeah, there's just not something we think of. But if we are able to think of that we have the free will, as I did not know that in that time, when I was in that kind of depressed state, I had no clue that free will was a thing. I had no awareness about this whole topic, that we actually choose our reality, that we have the opportunity to choose. But I did in that moment choose to ask, and I received for guidance. And that's something I want to share here too, that, you know, we are never alone, and we can ask literally whatever you would like to ask for, even if it's like a spirit animal that wants, like, has to show up right now in your reality to ask for it. You know, I do this sometimes too. If you feel in a certain situation, or you feel a little bit of fear, or maybe a situation where you want to have that little bit more of strength, you maybe can call upon your personal loving guide, because you have to be so careful with this, of course, your personal loving guide that is a lion, or that is anything of this matter. You know, we will know when it is our guide, when it brings us back to us, to love and not more fear or worry or anything. But you know that we can always ask for guidance. And in those moments where we felt, where we feel, or where we felt, you know, not that good, our future self was already talking to us. This is why I want to make this video today, that my future self gave this message. And in the past, I actually already knew this, that I would stay alive to be able to be here now to share this message, and then to be actually sharing this message to my past self, but as well to you all out there that need this message today. You don't have to have anything going on, but you're still so important, still important, still significant. Anything you do, your presence, your aura, your whole vibrational energy is such a big thing in the greater whole of all. Even, you know, if we learned that we don't matter, but we do, because we are matter right now. We always matter because we are literally physical matter. And that is so cool, and that's something I want to share today as a message to really see for yourself today. If you received this message, if this was guided towards you, to see where you're not seeing your significance, where you're not seeing your importance, and to give yourself that importance as you deserve it. To give yourself love, to just our small things, you know, even allowing yourself to watch this video is an act of love, because you allow someone else to share it with you and you can receive it. And that is an act of love for yourself, to receive a message that can uplift you. Hopefully, you know, I just do this because I follow my inner light and the hope that it will reach someone and maybe awaken someone's light too, but I have no control over that. And that is the magic of magical consciousness on this channel. So thank you all so much for watching. If you want to like, if you want to subscribe to the channel, it would be amazing to show up for yourself, even if it's the most bad weather outside. If you feel like you just want to sleep, that's okay too, you know, you just have to follow. But I love to give myself that extra little push in uncomfortability, to be uncomfortable, to feel like, you know, that's something, you know, if you do that, if you put yourself in a state of, you show up for yourself, you put yourself in a light, you see where, you know, you're not allowing yourself to shine. As I saw that, I had to cry because of love being present in this moment, as fear would not allow you to, you know, show emotions or cry or anything this matter. But my heart opened because I choose love in this present moment to share this message today, even if it felt hard or difficult or anything of this matter, to just know that however you show up, it's important, it's beautiful, and that you are significant. So have all a beautiful day today and make it magical. Yay.